Former Tesla employee has a secret improving EV batteries by 50%. This company is basically reinventing the lithium-ion battery. Lithium-ion batteries will power the electric vehicles and wider energy revolution we need to tackle the climate crisis. But they need to get much better. Also, in this report you will learn about iron flow battery technology from ESS, which is being deployed at scale in the United States, and could eat lithium-ion batteries lunch. Welcome back, friends. Please subscribe to Torque News YouTube and give us thumbs up for daily EV and Tesla news discussions. Christy Hemclock reports in The Wire that in 2003, Gene Berdichevsky heard about a group of entrepreneurs who were planning to build electric sports cars for the US market called Tesla. He was an undergraduate at Stanford University, and he'd become fascinated by the energy industry. He'd been building lightweight solar-powered cars that ran on lithium-ion batteries and racing them across the country. Berdichevsky had calculated that the energy density of lithium-ion made it possible to build real cars that could go almost 500 kilometers on a single charge, and had even written a business plan based on this idea. 6 months later, he dropped out of Stanford to join those entrepreneurs and became Tesla's seventh employee. But the more time he spent at the company, the more frustrated he got with the state of the battery industry. By today, the whole world should have been electric, he says. But performance was flatlining, price declines were slowing down, and new battery technologies that promised to replace lithium-ion were still decades away. Berdichevsky left Tesla and went back to Stanford to study for a master's in materials science, aiming to explore potential solutions. But he realized that any new technology would need to slot into existing manufacturing processes if it was going to catch on. The solar industry offered a cautionary tale, where incremental improvements and price drops in incumbent silicon-based solar drove innovators out of business. The answer, he decided, wasn't to replace lithium-ion but to make it better. In 2011, he founded Sila Nanotechnologies with Georgia Tech engineering professor Gleb Yushin and Tesla colleague Alex Jacobs. The company is aiming to make lithium-ion up to 50% better by replacing the anode, one of the four key components of batteries, which also have a cathode, a separator and an electrolyte. Lithium ions shuttle from anode to cathode through the electrolyte when a battery is used, and in the opposite direction when it's charged. The anode is usually made of graphite, but Sila has created one composed primarily of nano-engineered silicon, which can hold about 24 times as much lithium without swelling and degrading, so a battery of the same size can hold a lot more power. This will be vital for decarbonizing freight and aviation. This 50% improvement we're delivering, absolutely it will enable long-haul trucking, it will enable electric flight, Berdichevsky says, although he says electric flight will probably only ever be viable for short regional trips. Sila is working with BMW and Daimler on electric vehicles, and with other partners on consumer devices to be announced later this year. When products hit the market, within 6 months, Berdichevsky says, they'll represent the biggest change in battery technology since the early 1990s, when lithium and cobalt-based batteries first reached consumers in the Sony Walkman. One of the concerns about lithium-ion is the negative impact of lithium and cobalt extraction on communities and the environment in South America, Asia, and Africa. That, and rising lithium prices, has been one of the drivers behind the bevy of new energy storage technologies being touted, such as lithium-sulfur, aluminium-ion and carbon-based supercapacitors. But lithium is one of the smallest and lightest elements. Those chemical bonds are some of the strongest you can make per unit of weight and volume, Berdichevsky says. From a scientific standpoint, it's hard to see what that replacement is. And it's not fundamentally scarce, he argues. You can extract it from seawater if you need to. Sila's strategy of improving the incumbent technology is certainly paying off on the investment side. It recently raised $600 million to finance a new production line, and although the company has no plans to build its own batteries, in the coming years it will build a plant capable of providing anode materials for the power cells of a million vehicles, or a billion consumer devices. By focusing on just one part of the technology rather than trying to reinvent the whole battery, Sila has been able to bring improved energy storage products to the market now, and in a way that can be integrated into existing production lines, while other technologies are still years away. Further improvements to the other parts of the battery may squeeze even more juice out of lithium-ion further down the line, and get us to where we need to be to tackle climate change. It's a revolution in parts, Berdichevsky says. We also need new types of iron batteries for our grid. Akshat Rati reports in Bloomberg that the world's electric grids are creaking under the pressure of volatile fossil fuel prices and the imperative of weaning the world off polluting energy sources. A solution may be at hand, thanks to an innovative battery that's a cheaper alternative to lithium-ion technology. SB Energy Corporation, a U.S. renewable energy firm that's an arm of Japan's SoftBank Group Corporation, is making a record purchase of the batteries manufactured by ESS Incorporated. The Oregon company says it has new technology that can store renewable energy for longer and help overcome some of the reliability problems that have caused blackouts in California and record high energy prices in Europe. The units, which rely on something called iron flow chemistry, will be used in utility-scale solar projects dotted across the U.S., allowing those power plants to provide electricity for hours after the sun sets. SB Energy will buy enough batteries over the next 5 years to power 50,000 American homes for a day. Long-duration energy storage, like this iron flow battery, are key to adding more renewables to the grid, said Venkat Viswanathan, a battery expert and associate professor of mechanical engineering at Carnegie Mellon University. ESS was founded in 2011 by Craig Evans, now president, and Julia Song, the chief technology officer. They recognize that while lithium-ion batteries will play a key role in electrification of transport, longer-duration grid-scale energy storage needed a different battery. That's because while the price of lithium-ion batteries has declined 90% over the last decade, their ingredients, which sometimes include expensive metals such as cobalt and nickel, limit how low the price can fall. The deal for 2 gigawatt-hours of batteries is worth at least $300 million, according to ESS. Rich Hossfeld, chief executive officer of SB Energy, said the genius of the units lies in their simplicity. The battery is made of iron, salt and water, said Hossfeld. Unlike lithium-ion batteries, iron flow batteries are really cheap to manufacture. Every battery has four components, two electrodes between which charged particles shuffle as the battery is charged and discharged, electrolyte that allows the particles to flow smoothly and a separator that prevents the two electrodes from forming a short circuit. Flow batteries, however, look nothing like the battery inside smartphones or electric cars. That's because the electrolyte needs to be physically moved using pumps as the battery charges or discharges. That makes these batteries large, with ESS's main products sold inside a shipping container. What they take up in space, they can make up in cost. Lithium-ion batteries for grid-scale storage can cost as much as $350 per kilowatt-hour. But ESS says its battery could cost $200 per kilowatt-hour or less by 2025. Crucially, adding storage capacity to cover longer interruptions at a solar or wind plant may not require purchasing an entirely new battery. Flow batteries require only extra electrolyte, which in ESS's case can cost as little as $20 per kilowatt-hour. This is a big, big deal, said Eric Toon, science lead at Breakthrough Energy Ventures, which has invested in ESS. We've been talking about flow batteries forever and ever, and now it's actually happening. The U.S. National Aeronautics and Space Administration built a flow battery as early as 1980. Because these batteries used water, they presented a much safer option for space applications than lithium-ion batteries developed around that time, which were infamous for catching on fire. Hossfeld says he's been able to get permits for ESS batteries, even in wildfire-prone California, that wouldn't have been given to lithium-ion versions. Still, there was a problem with iron flow batteries. During charging, the battery can produce a small amount of hydrogen, which is a symptom of reactions that, left unchecked, shorten the battery's life. ESS's main innovation, said Song, was a way of keeping any hydrogen produced within the system and thus hugely extending its life. As soon as you close the loop on hydrogen, you suddenly turn a lab prototype into a commercially viable battery option, said Viswanathan. ESS's iron flow battery can endure more than 20 years of daily use without losing much performance, said Hossfeld. At the company's factory near Portland, yellow robots cover plastic sheets with chemicals and glue them together to form the battery cores. Inside the shipping containers, vats full of electrolyte feed into each electrode through pumps, allowing the battery to do its job of absorbing renewable power when the sun shines and releasing it when it gets dark. It's a promising first step. ESS's battery is a cheap solution that can currently provide about 12 hours of storage, but utilities will eventually need batteries that can last much longer as more renewables are added to the grid. Earlier this month, for example, the lack of storage contributed to a record spike in power prices across the UK, when wind speeds remained low for weeks. Startups such as Form Energy Incorporated are also using iron, an abundant and cheap material, to build newer forms of batteries that could beat ESS on price. So far, ESS has commercially deployed 8 megawatt-hours of iron flow batteries. Last week, after a six-month evaluation, Spanish utility Enel Green Power Spa signed a single deal for ESS to build an equivalent amount. SB Energy's Hossfeld, who also sits on ESS's board, said the company would likely buy still more battery capacity from ESS in the next 5 years. Even as its order books fill up, ESS faces a challenging road ahead. Bringing new batteries to market is notoriously difficult, and the sector is littered with failed startups. Crucially, lithium-ion technology got a head start and customers are more familiar with its pros and cons. ESS will have to prove that its batteries can meet the rigorous demands of power plant operators. The new order should help ESS as it looks to go public within weeks through a special purpose acquisition company at a valuation of $1.07 billion. The listing will net the company $465 million, which it plans to use to scale up its operations.